Welcome to another video from Far North Bushcraft and Survival. Hello, my name is Lonnie, and behind the camera is my wife. And we would like to take this opportunity to thank each one of our viewers and our subscribers. You guys are awesome. I might add our dog Buck is with us too. He's the one running around here. Okay, I'd like to take this opportunity to thank Jeremiah, I think he said his name was. A couple days ago, we were in town and picking up supplies and taking care of business, and a young fella and his son walked up to us and introduced himself. And he said, I want to thank you. He says, I know you guys. He says, I recognize you from YouTube. He said, I want to thank you for all the videos you've put up. He says, they've really helped me a lot. And I'd like to take this opportunity, my wife and I would, to thank you guys, to thank Jeremiah and all the rest of you guys for subscribing and viewing our videos. We've been growing like crazy. The last 30 days alone, we've got new subscribers from 83 different countries. And that just blows me away. And I'd like to thank you guys. Now, on to the main feature, as they say. Through the years, there's been a skill that I've learned years ago that have been really useful to me. I've used it a lot. I've been really glad that somebody took the time many years ago to show me. So I'd like to show you, and that is rope lashing. There's two lashing techniques that have been especially useful, and that's tripod lashing and square lashing. We're going to start out today with tripod lashing. Okay, to start out, you want to tie a clove hitch. I'm not going to demonstrate real closely how to tie a clove hitch. There's many great videos on the internet already showing how to do that. Now, there's several different methods of doing tripod lashing. One of the methods is to go in front of and behind, in front of and behind, in front of and behind, weaving around each of the poles in the tripod. Just like that, over and over and over. Well, for me, that they always seem to end up being too loose. So I'm going to show you how I do it. And not only is it more simple, but for me it works better. We're doing this video in our driveway, so from time to time you might hear cars pass or snow machines. All right, we're going to wrap around all three poles about three times, or I mean about five times or so. Okay, there's four. No, that's five. Okay, now we'll do what they call frapping. We will wrap around this outside pole and then start going in between the poles. And you want to make sure this is fairly tight. Sometimes it can be quite difficult to get the ropes in between each of the poles here when their poles are real straight, but this is an important step in the lashing. So you gotta get it tight. Okay, we've wrapped around that three times. Now we're going to go to the next one and wrap around it three times. Excuse me. Lunch is talking back to me. Okay, there's two. And there's three. All right. Now, many people finish this off with a clove hitch again. Personally, I like using a square knot. It just seems to stay tighter for me. There, there's the tripod lashing. Now let's stand it up. Okay, now, when you, to set this up, you take the outside poles here, cross the bottoms towards each other, like that. There we go. All right, that's good and secure. I can put my whole weight on this thing and it won't slip. Many of you have seen my video, simple bushcraft chair, and there's many other videos similar to that on the internet. This is how you put together your tripod for the bushcraft chair. Now I'm gonna be back here in a little bit after I've got this all taken apart, and we'll show you the square lashing. All right, we've got the tripod all taken apart and untied. Let's get started on the square lashing. Again, just like the tripod, you start out with a clove hitch. Okay. Now, this one you go over and under. Over and under. Over and under. Just keep repeating that about 5-6 times. What they call the frapping again, just like in the tripod video. You wrap around in between the poles about 3 times. Boy, I'm not sure I got enough. Yeah, this will work. And then again, I like to finish it off with a square knot, tying the two ends together. There, there's our square lashing. That's great for making a framework of poles for any number of uses. Now that should be plenty sturdy enough to put my full weight on as well without it slipping, if I can do it without falling. Okay. Okay, well there you go. Through the years, like I said, I found the knowledge to know how to lash, very useful. And I hope it serves you well as well. Thanks for watching. We'll see you on the next video.